breaking news from Alabama. They just shot him dead. It began as a possible mutual altercation between two teenagers in a parking lot but then escalated quickly into a five-person capital murder charge. There may have been a fistfight, a screaming match, or an altercation of some sort, but it ended in the parking lot with both parties going their separate ways in different cars. But that's not where it ended. It didn't stop until someone's life was taken and five people were locked up. Six people's lives ended the night. One dead, five others facing stiff prison sentences. The scary part is that no one has a motive. The scary part is that these are high school students engaging in murderous crimes. What happened to the classic fist fight, handshake, and go your way or drink a brew together? Those days are sometimes an ancient memory, the days where people had respect for each other, win or lose, and they valued their life more than anything as they forbid weapons to be part of their fights. But nowadays everyone whips out a gun. This story is no different, but it's scary, horrible, and a shame what's happening to some of the youth. It makes you wonder if these boys have a father figure who instills respect and morals into their children. It was just another day for most teenagers. Texting, Facebook, video games, but not for this group. This group had their altercation in a parking lot, then having a one-way shootout that left one boy dead in a hospital. One of the main suspects, possibly the shooter, was a high school football star who reportedly had several college scholarships. Now he likely has zero. If found guilty, he'll be old, washed up, and probably not get into college on any sports scholarship. I'm not sure any school will give a scholarship to murderers. They might teach a gender studies class that no one can get a job with, but I'm reasonably certain no school provides free tuition for killers. Zero. Shares. Facebook. Twitter. It began as a possible mutual altercation between two teenagers in a parking lot but then escalated quickly into a five-person capital murder charge. There may have been a fistfight, a screaming match, or an altercation of some sort, but it ended in the parking lot with both parties going their separate ways in different cars. But that's not where it ended. It didn't stop until someone's life was taken and five people were locked up. Six people's lives ended the night. One dead, five others facing stiff prison sentences. The scary part is that no one has a motive. The scary part is that these are high school students engaging in murderous crimes. What happened to the classic fist fight, handshake, and go your way or drink a brew together? Those days are sometimes an ancient memory, the days where people had respect for each other, win or lose, and they valued their life more than anything as they forbid weapons to be part of their fights. But nowadays everyone whips out a gun. This story is no different, but it's scary, horrible, and a shame what's happening to some of the youth. It makes you wonder if these boys have a father figure who instills respect and morals into their children. It was just another day for most teenagers. Texting, Facebook, video games, but not for this group. This group had their altercation in a parking lot, then having a one-way shootout that left one boy dead in a hospital. One of the main suspects, possibly the shooter, was a high school football star who reportedly had several college scholarships. Now he likely has zero. If found guilty, he'll be old, washed up, and probably not get into college on any sports scholarship. I'm not sure any school will give a scholarship to murderers. They might teach a gender studies class that no one can get a job with, but I'm reasonably certain no school provides free tuition for killers. Daily Mail reports. A high school football star from Alabama has been charged with the murder of an 18-year-old. Jesse Altman, a 17-year-old junior at Utah High, was taken into custody on Wednesday over the shooting death of Aaron A.J. Huff in Gadsden, northeast of Birmingham, last week. Altman and four other teenagers have all been charged with capital murder. The other four must be an accomplice, as they could not have helped the shooter pull the trigger, but they may have encouraged it or taken him there to do it. That makes them all guilty in one way or another. However, if it's reported that anyone told the football star not to shoot the other teen, then perhaps they have a chance in court. Someone needs to be imprisoned for this for a very long time if the shooting victim was unarmed and had already left the scene. Anytime a shooter chases someone down like this, it should be considered extra violent. Both parties had left the parking lot, so why escalate this again? Now, look what happened. More from the Daily Mail. Authorities say the shooting took place following an altercation in a parking lot at about 7:30 p.m. on January 4. Broderick Lawrence Pearson, 18, Lontario Orlando Harrison, 17, Galab Blake Whitworth, 16, and Tyler Michael Abbott, 17, were the others charged in the shooting death. Altman is known in the area for being a standout on the high school's football roster, the Gadsden Times reports. He is a three-star, 285-pound defensive tackle recruit in the class of 2019. Prior to his arrest, Altman reportedly already had several scholarship offers for several top American college football programs, including Texas, West Virginia, Oregon, Kentucky, and Mississippi State. This crime is a travesty on all accounts. So many lives were lost on this tragic night. One boy lost his life physically, and the others ruined their lives as well. The families will all mourn the victim, and the other families will visit their child in prison. Is this any way for any teenagers to live their lives? What happened to kids having morals and respect after an altercation? Why are the kids running around with a gun? Where are the parents and where did they go wrong? Or was it the kids who ran with the wrong crowd? It's unfortunate that police don't yet have a motive for the shooting. What if we find out the victim was the bully? If that's the case, then the football star could have simply knocked some sense into the shooting victim. Why shoot someone? If we find out that the shooting victim raped the football star's sister or did something inhumane to someone in his family, then I'll probably congratulate the shooter. However, no matter what someone does to your family, you cannot throw your own life away in retaliation. We cannot let someone else have that power over us. Or, we just can't get caught. Stay tuned for the motive because this story can go in a million different directions.